accepted, I'm forgiven, I am fathered by the true and living God. I'm accepted, no condemnation, I am loved by the true and living God. There's no guilt or fear as I draw near to the Savior and Creator of the world. There is joy and peace as I release my worship to you, O Lord. I'm accepted, I'm forgiven, I am fathered by the true and living God. I'm accepted, no condemnation, I am loved by the true and living God. There's no guilt or fear as I draw near to the Savior and Creator of the world. There is joy and peace as I release my worship to you, O Lord. There's no guilt or fear as I draw near to the Savior and Creator of the world. There is joy and peace as I release my worship to you, O Lord.
To light and lights in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for a new day. We thank you for friendship. We thank you for fellowship. We come before you and ask that you would guide us through this day in all that's said and all that's done, in our joys and in our frustrations. Be the God who is before us, the God who is beside us, the God who walks with us in all that's said and done. Amen. Well, we're going to have a little sing-song. I'm accepted. I'm accepted. I'm forgiven. And then we're going to go to Jacqui for a reading. Or I think it's Marcel that's reading.
No, we were just joking.
Just all right, okay.
A few days later, Jesus entered Capernaum again. Sorry, a reading from Mark 2. It's thrown me completely. A few days later, Jesus entered Capernaum again. The people heard that he had come home. So many people gathered that there was no room left. There was not even room outside the door. And Jesus preached the word to them. Four of those who came were carrying a man who could not walk. But they could not get him close to Jesus because of the crowd. So they made a hole by digging through the roof above Jesus. Then they lowered the man through it on a mat. Jesus saw their faith, so he said to the man, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Some teachers of the law were sitting there. They were thinking, "Why is this fellow talking like that? He's saying a very evil thing. Only God can forgive sins." Right away, Jesus knew what they were thinking. So he said to them, "Why are you thinking these things? Is it easier to say to this man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or to say, 'Get up, take your mat, and walk'? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. So Jesus spoke to the man who could not walk. I tell you, he said, get up, take your mat, and go home. The man got up and took his mat. Then he walked away while everyone watched. All the people were amazed. They praised God and said, we have never seen anything like this.
At this time, a lot of people were asking, you know, why doesn't God do something? Why doesn't God heal everyone that's prayed for? And there's always that question about, did Jesus come just to heal? Did he come just to fulfill our wishes? As though God was at our beck and call to do whatever we wanted him to do for us? Or did God in Christ Jesus come with a deeper mission? What is the greatest need of humanity? Jesus forgave the man's sins. Our deepest need, in some ways, is for spiritual healing. To be made whole with God. So as we pray, not all people are made physically well. But the promise is that all who ask for forgiveness are forgiven and welcomed in. So let us turn and pray for all who are in need at this time, knowing that our hearts want to touch everyone to be healed, asking God to be merciful, asking God to help us to be patient. I don't believe it's God's will for any of us to become ill or to die. That's not the picture we're given. Yet the picture we're given today is of a man who comes and meets the deepest needs of humanity. He forgives sins. And the ultimate picture is that through the forgiveness of sins, healing takes place, healing for us as individuals, for us as a creation. Eternal life is given. So we come to the God who is in control. Let us pray. Lord, help us to know that we are accepted and that we are forgiven and that your heart is for us. And although we cannot fathom your ways, for your ways are higher and wider and longer than we can ever understand, help us to trust in you, to know that you welcome us in, that you long to hear from us, that you long to touch and to embrace us by the presence of your Spirit. And so we come as children with many cares, many concerns on our hearts and minds. And we pray this day. We pray for Megan. Lord, in the midst of her anxiety and worry, we pray for peace. Help her to be calm. Help those who care for her to support and give her that sense of love and care around her. And we pray that these tests and investigations would get to the bottom of this issue. And that you indeed, Lord, through that love, that care, that wisdom would bring about restoration. We pray for Lou and for David, for Gregor and Alison, and their worries and their concerns. Lord, help us all to trust in you in the midst of their storm. We pray too for Ali Wilson. Lord, we thank you for Ali and all that she does for the young people through running the church youth groups. We pray for Jamie and their family. And Lord, we pray that you would strengthen Ali and restore and return her to us. We pray for Dorothy Brand. We thank you for her love and her care towards Robert for the many years of life. And Lord, we pray for Dorothy. Lord, if it's your will to restore her back home, or at this time to open the gates into that new heavenly dwelling for her, may she know peace and comfort this day. And Lord, we give thanks too for Catriona and Mitch returning home, and for Lily, for Matt and Leslie and Bea, that this time would be a time of refreshing, of relief, and of new beginnings for them, for their household. We pray too for Kate Blaymeyer as she returns home. Comfort them in the grief of the loss of a young life. But restore them, Lord. And of course, we pray for all who have passed away, for their families, for those who mourn. And especially, we continue to pray for Roger, for Shan and the family, for David Hall and Margaret and her family, and for Iris to lose, for Pam and Neil and their families. Lord, watch over them. Help them to grieve, help them to mourn, but bring them many happy memories of the loved ones loved yet lost this day. So, Lord, watch over us. Guide us all as your children. Help us to know your acceptance, your forgiveness afresh. Whatever may come, help us to bless your holy name. Amen. So may the Lord bless you and keep you. May he make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he make himself known to you as you go through this day in the beauty of creation that's around us. Enjoy the sunshine. I hope you can get out. So go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope and you restore every heart that is broken. Sing it to him. Great are you, Lord, 'cause it's your breath in our lungs. So we pour out our praise, we pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs. So we singing. You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness. You give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise. We pour out our praise. It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise to you only. It's your breath. Bones will sing.